morning, students. So in the previous class, we had dealt with encephalitis, and before that we had dealt with meningitis. So these are the infectious disease of the brain, where meningitis is nothing but inflammation of the meninges, and in encephalitis it is the inflammation of the brain. And the encephalitis in the previous class, like from definition to management, we had dealt with. So today we'll go on with the next infectious disease of brain, that is brain abscess. So now, what is this brain abscess? So when we talk about this brain abscess, it is usually a bacterial brain infection. Okay, it is usually a bacterial brain infection, which is also called as cerebral abscess. Okay, Okay, so this is bacterial brain infection, which is also called as cerebral abscess. Okay, it is also called as cerebral abscess, and this. When we talk about this abscess, is usually a liquefied filled center. Okay, this abscess is usually a liquefied filled center which consists of bacteria, fluid, and WBC. Okay, so this abscess is usually a liquefied fluid center which consists of WBC, bacteria, and fluid. So this fluid which is present in the abscess is usually called as pus. Okay, the fluid which is present in the abscess is usually called as pus. So this is usually about the definition of brain abscess. So brain abscess is usually a bacterial brain infection which is also called as cerebral abscess, and this abscess is usually a liquefied filled center which consists of bacteria, fluid, and WBC. And the fluid which is present in this abscess, it is usually called as pus. So brain abscess usually occurs when bacteria enters into the brain. Okay, so brain abscess usually occurs when bacteria enters into the brain. So what will happen, it is that when bacteria enters into the brain, so it causes first cerebritis, then the area is inflamed, and then infection starts occurring. So when the infection becomes very severe, it leads to the formation of pus. Okay, it leads to the formation of pus. So what will happen is that this brain abscess occurs when bacteria enters into the brain. So when it enters in the brain, what is occurring? So there will be cerebritis. So this cerebritis, cerebritis usually occurs. So after this cerebritis, usually the area is inflamed. So once the area is inflamed, the infection starts occurring. So once the infection becomes severe, that usually leads to this formation of pus. So this is about this brain abscess. Understood? So what is brain abscess? Brain abscess is nothing but bacterial brain infection, which is usually called as cerebral abscess. And what is this abscess now? Abscess, it is usually a liquefied fluid filled center, which consists of bacteria, WBC, and fluid. And this fluid which is present inside the abscess is usually called as pus. So bacterial brain abscess usually occurs when bacteria enters into the brain. So this is about this definition. So next is causes. So when we talk about this causes, brain is usually a sterile one. Inside as well as surrounding the brain, it is usually a sterile one. So the abscess, there are a number of things which can introduce bacteria into the brain. In the definition only I said you that brain abscess occurs when bacteria enters into the brain. Okay, brain abscess occurs when bacteria enters into the brain. But in generally, brain is usually a sterile one. Okay, in generally, the brain is usually a sterile one. So there are many things which is there which usually introduces this bacteria into the brain. Okay, there are many things which introduces this bacteria into brain. So that is usually the infections to the other area. Okay, so that is mainly the infections to the other area, like ear infection, paranasal sinuses, then dental abscess, or infection to the lung, heart, and kidney, or if there is infection to the mastoid air cell of the temporal bone. Okay, if there is infection to the mastoid air cell of the temporal bone. So these are usually the infection which usually causes this. It is usually the infection which usually causes this brain abscess, or introduces the bacteria into the brain. Okay, which introduces the bacteria into the brain. So there are certain people who are risk of developing this brain abscess. Okay, there are risk factors which usually leads to this brain abscess. It includes if the person is having weak immune system. So this weak immune system will be seen if the person is suffering from AIDS. Okay, there are certain risk factors which usually leads to brain abscess. So it mainly includes such as in case when the person is suffering from AIDS, or if next is that if the person is having a chronic disease such as cancer, or if the person is taking drugs which suppresses the immune system. Okay, the drug which suppresses the immune system such as corticosteroids and chemotherapy, okay, corticosteroids and chemotherapy. So these are the risk factors which usually leads to this brain abscess. So this is about this causes. So normally causes bacteria, brain is usually sterile. So there are many factors which introduces the bacteria into the brain. So it might be due to some other infections. So what are the infections that usually it will be there? So such as ear infection, dental abscess, paranasal sinuses, infection to the lung, heart and kidney. And next, in case of if there is infection to the mastoid air cell of the temporal bone. And there are certain risk factors which might lead to brain abscess, and includes if there is weak immune system, such as in case of AIDS, and if there is a chronic disease, that is cancer, or if they are using drugs which suppresses the immune system, such as corticosteroids or chemotherapy. So in the definition, I have told you that it is in the beginning of the causes, I have told you that it mainly causes due to bacteria. So now we'll see which are the bacteria which causes this brain abscess. So the bacteria which causes this brain abscess, it is mainly Staphylococcus and Streptococcus. So the bacteria which causes this brain abscess, it is mainly Staphylococcus and Streptococcus. In few instances, it is also caused by fungus. So the fungus which causes this bacterial brain abscess, it is mainly Candida. Okay, the fungus which usually causes this brain abscess, it is usually Candida. So this is usually about the causes of brain abscess. In the beginning of the cause only, I have told that it is mainly caused by bacteria also. It is mainly caused by bacteria. So which are the bacteria which causes this brain abscess? It includes Staphylococcus and Streptococcus. And in few instances, it is also seen that it is also caused by fungus. The fungus which causes this brain abscess, it is usually Candida. Okay, it is usually Candida. So this is usually about this causes of brain abscess. Okay, this is usually about this causes of brain abscess. So next we'll move on with the pathophysiology. So in the definition as well as in the causes also, I have told that it might be due to bacteria or fungi. So when this bacteria or fungi enters into the body, it usually occurs on entry of this bacteria or fungi into the brain. The first thing it does is inflammation starts occurring. Okay, Once inflammation starts occurring, it leads to infection of that area. Okay, So what is that? The starting of this, it usually occurs on the entry of bacteria or fungi. When it enters, it leads to inflammation of that area. Once the inflammation starts occurring, so that usually leads to this, infection of that particular area. So when infection develops, this leads to the, so when this infection starts developing, the WBC starts working. So the WBC, what it does, it joins to fight against the infection. So now the WBC starts working, it joins against the that usually leads to a membrane. It starts developing a membrane around that area. Okay, it starts developing a membrane around that infected portion of the brain. Okay, so it starts developing a membrane around the infected portion of the brain. So that usually leads, it's that it usually presses the brain. Okay, it usually presses the brain tissue. Okay, so when this infected, when this organ is like, when this membrane is prepared, or when this, and it creates a membrane around this brain tissue or the affected portion of the brain. So that usually presses the brain. Okay, that usually presses the brain. That usually this usually forms the pus. So once there is pus formation in the brain, okay, once there is pus formation in the brain, that will block the blood supply to the infected area. Okay, so that blocks the blood supply to the infected area. So that usually leads to this brain damage. Okay, that usually leads to this brain damage. So pathophysiology, when we are talking, so when we are seeing this pathology on the entry of this bacteria or fungi, okay, on the entry of this bacteria and fungi, that usually leads to the inflammation of that area. So once inflammation starts developing, that usually leads to the infection of that particular area. So when infection starts occurring, WBC starts its functioning, that it joins to fight against the infection. So and then it creates, after that, it creates a membrane around the infected portion of the brain. So that will give a pressure on the brain tissue. Okay, that will give a pressure on the brain tissue, that leads to formation of pus. So once this pus is formed, it blocks the blood supply to the brain or the infected portion of the brain. That usually leads to this brain damage. So this is about this pathophysiology of the brain abscess. So we have in this video we are studying we studied about this brain definition. So what is definition? Brain abscess is nothing but bacterial brain infection, which is also called a cerebral abscess. So what is this abscess? Abscess is, it is a liquefied filled, fluid filled center which consists of fluid, bacteria and WBC. So what will happen is that when bacteria enters into the brain, it causes this infection, abscess or infection. So so that is usually about this brain abscess causes we have seen, and also we have seen this pathophysiology. Remaining we'll see in the next video.